Hi. In mijn computer, I have a Samsung SSD, an 840 Pro, from 265 gigabyte. So as you can see, the performance is not bad. I read from 405 MB a second and write 375. It's not bad, but it can be better. I can buy a newer version of SSD, a little bit larger, with a larger cache memory, so it will perform better. But the bottleneck will be the SATA 600 bus. Yeah, this computer is almost 3 years old, so I find a solution. This Intel 750. It must be a lot faster, about 2000 MB a second and a writing of 1300 a second. It's a PCI connector, not SATA, not bottleneck. It's quite expensive, about 430 euros. A lot of money, but when you want to go fast, you have to pay. All the computers must support UEFI BIOS to support booting without a SATA controller. So what I do the first time, I upgrade the BIOS of my computer to the latest version because I read on several forums. You can use you have to check the chipset if it supports the type of BIOS and supporting this Intel. Now I have an Asus Rampage 4, and official it won't support, but in the BIOS and some setting in the BIOS you can make it boot. So you can see I boot the BIOS already. I make a USB stick with a complete set of Windows 10. Windows 10 have the benefit of native support of PCIe booting. With older version of Windows, you have to manage with drivers and other crap, and will be hard to do. So I gonna put the Intel card in my computer. And let's find out if I can make it booted easy. I install Intel into my computer. Of course, I use anti-static strip. Like always, first pull the switch on the power supply, then push on the button, so all condensers in the computer will be empty. So no damage will be done. I insert the card, and you can see I'm just running my old Windows 7 installation, and I install a driver. I need one, no, very tiny disk, and then I can the computer can communicate with the card, and I do a benchmark. I use HDTune. Other tools won't recognize the card, and I can see on the right performs about 1900 MB a second, and the average 850. Now HDTune is very conservative. The most other benchmarks will be a little bit higher, but I'm only interested in daily use performance and not only on the best circumstances for the best performance. I want performance I can use all day, and not only when I pull off my 4D scanner and make some tweaks on some circumstances I can have the maximum power. Okay, that's done. Now I can program the BIOS to change the way to the boot system. Then I let me figure out that if I can install Windows 10 on it. I also install Windows 10 instead of my Windows 7. I buy a bigger screen, Ultra HD. I found out that Windows 7 can deal with it, but not as good as Windows 10 can. I need to change a lot of customizing if I can read the letters on my screen. Okay, let's find out how I have to change the BIOS. Okay, I'm back in the BIOS. I show you which changes I make to get boot able from the PC card. First of all, I go to boot over here. Then I go to setup mode, computer support module, CSM. You have to choose for the advanced mode of the BIOS, not AZ. If you choose for AZ, you have to have of the possibilities of your motherboard installation. I'm there. You can see here the boot options and prioriteit. You can see here all. Okay, and in the CSM now, and use the boot from PCIe expansion devices, and I select UEFI driver first. So window get it from here. The other stuff I lead on UEFI Alexi oprom, otherwise you can't boot from a stick or a DVD. You can make several changes, but it's not needed. That's the only thing I change. I already installed Windows 10. This is an USB 2. Not that fast stick is this, about 25-30 MB a second, but the whole installation of Windows 10 less than 10 minutes. And you can see I have a screen here. I have only to log in. And you can see I have Windows 10 on this computer. But a few points. This computer is not a new one, it's about 3 years old. And Rampage 4 from Asus. An X79 chipset on it. And I need to install a lot of hardware. It only sees not GeForce 780 OSA 22 video card, but that's not a real big thing. And install all the hardware. And of the Intel, I can only use 370 gig instead of the 400. And you lost some because of the partitioning of NTFS. But most SSD manufacturers put a little bit more in, so you always get what's on the box. I can install the whole system more, all drivers, and then I do some benchmark testing. Okay, the basic setup of Windows 10 is done. Even I already installed Office. Is done. On average use, you doesn't matter see a burst of more performance for but when you do something with few editing and then you make a lot difference in a higher performance. I noticed some benchmark software doesn't work properly, so I can't make a performance test on a Windows 10. But the performance under Windows 7 are very well. I'm satisfied. About 1900 MB a second. That's a lot more than my old SSD. And I already take off the connector of my old SSD. So I'm sure he's booting from the PCI Intel 750 card. And had no files on other devices in the computer. Thank you for watching this video. And, see you later. Bye.